Alright, so yeah, funny. I'm like, well, oh my gosh, the last few days, I have not been looking at the news, so I'm not in the scandal of that shock of oh, should I be depressed for in some kind of oh sad extra. So luckily, I haven't looked at the news for 2 days or 3 days. So yeah. So, but right now I've been looking at these because my father could pass away, you know, and if he does so, I have to have plans. So I'm like, well, what am I gonna do if I take my items, my little shop, and I go somewhere. So I'm like, well, I'm looking into all of these services. They have U-Haul, they have Penske, they have Pods, they have one called Packrat, which makes a really clever new little gadget on a truck, and they have U-Pack. Now these are all kind of interesting. They bring these items, and then you fill them up, and then they get shipped away. And so then I'm like, okay, that's great and wonderful. So I'm wondering which way to go. You know, am I gonna go? Well, I've been contemplating Roswell, because you know I'm not, with wealth here, so I've been contemplating Roswell, of all places. And then I'm like, well, when I was living in that area before in the past, it was kind of interesting, because. Oh my gosh, yeah. They had a meteor that showered there on my property. It was a meteor shower. And so there were a whole bunch of asteroidal meteors, whatever you call them. No, it wouldn't be a meteor shower. It was there were big rocks, big, huge black rocks from space, okay? And so they pounced into the earth, and they buried themselves and all kinds of things. So the whole time I was there, I had like these dreams that there were aliens nearby, you know. And I couldn't help it. It was just the way it goes. And so I always had these dreams. I even had a sighting once off my balcony. So interestingly, when they when I left the property. I had all kinds of fencing, like I don't know, like 10 acres worth of fencing that I hadn't put up. You know, it was like real fencing. And I put it all underneath the trailer. Okay, so it was all underneath there to keep it like rust free, because it's a rust, it I guess it would blow away in the wind, and I didn't want people to steal it, so I did all that. And then meanwhile I'm like, well, wait a minute, because when that asteroid thing hit, the rocks buried themselves underneath the trailer also. And so there's actually no technical proof that those little creatures are not underneath the trailer, you know, underneath the wire. And I'm like, well, wait a minute. So maybe indirectly they ordered like their own Faraday cage. So now I'm like, well, this is a cute little story that now I'm making up now. A cute little creative. Now this is a creative story. If you have problems with your creative sector of your brain, yeah, so these little dudes now have their own Faraday cage, and they're contacting me with all kinds of information, because obviously I'm their helper, you know. And so did they, in their night dreams, did they actually sneak, come on, go and put that wire above us so we are protected? Because they have, in that particular area, they have all of these military, whatever, sight seekers. They have those black op, what do you call them, those black helicopters go by. Those happen quite often. And they really are black. They're not gray, they're black. So it's really kind of an odd, interesting funny. So these little creatures. So this is just my creative elaboration, but they're, it's almost like we have a strange kinship, that group and me, you know. Maybe they're a little bit help in my you know, you always have like you have like a magic friend or whatever. Maybe these are more like my future helper tellers. You know, they help me discover. They help me discover and feel more in tune with the, what do you call it, the cycle of the planet itself and the direction. They've always been good. They've always been a good creative helper. They've always been very good. And yeah, and they're protected, obviously, now with the wire. So, because it's probably all still there. That's just the way it goes in that area of the world. Yeah, I don't know. Where to go? It's kind of funny. You know, obviously, my father, you know, and I'm like, let's do it, let's head out, let's go, you know, get a house somewhere, you know, let's, but, you know, I there's only so much I can push, there's almost so much I can push, you know, I've pushed this for 2 years almost, and I don't know, so, what to do, I made my little shop here on this internet, and I don't know. I don't want to sell it fast. I don't want to sell these items quickly because in a way there's no reason to. Why do I have to sell them quickly? You know, if they're items that I can sell over the next 5-10 years, why do I feel have to feel rushed and pushed by these people who say, get a job, go to work. No. Why do I have to be rushed and pushed by that group? So this comes down to that. I was reading a forum about people who are the ones that are near their elders, the children that are near their elder, and yeah, it's interesting. I found out because this is something that seems to happen as people age. There is a creep up of anxiety because their bodies change. Their bodies are changing, and so with that body change, there's a creep in this anxiety, and so they end up with all these extra resentments and these extra grumbles, and then you hear like, oh, that's a grouchy old man, or that's a grumpy old woman, that's a bitter woman, or that's a grumpy old man, and this is just like again and again and again and again, a real, you know, and so you have the get out of my garden, you know, that type of a person, get right, you know, that type of thing goes on, and you know where they're just like immediately going to pounce with a no, a negative, you know. So what I've been reading is because the brain shrinks as we age, you know, that means with the shrinkage you have shallower and shallower mind thought potential. Which is kind of sad, isn't it? So when before you were like, well, you can go here, you can go there, you can do this other, you know, you have that adventure spirit. Oh my God. Yeah, it really, really shrinks, and you don't have that adventure spirit. You're like, well, I can go to the store down the street rather than the state over there or the country way over there, you know. Yeah, so all of this is just this real, you know, and it's not necessarily classed as fear. It's just the brain shrinking. And maybe we see it or perceive it as fear, but yeah, I guess one day we'll find out that fear does equal brain shrink, or, you know, that's very interesting, isn't it? So I'm like, okay, so how do we stop it? And then they're like, well, give them some low antidepressants. That's what they're saying. All over. All these old people that are disingenuous and unkind. They need low, what do they call them? Low volume, low whatever. Yeah, it has to be a low amount of it. It can't be a high amount of antidepressant, but a low amount. And I'm like, well, does it have to be the medical chemical version with the heavy metals? Can we go another route? And then I looked up everything, and I'm like, okay, St. John's wort, and it just says St. John's wort again and again and again and again. As a really good thing for older people, the older they get, and ginkgo biloba, and that's it. I couldn't find anything else, so I'm a little shocked. I wanted more. I wanted much more. But those are the herbs that we have. Those are the highlighted ones, and so yeah, let's think about that. So the older we get, as our mind is shrinking, shriveling in essence, we have to fortify it from doing that. And I imagine the ginkgo biloba, it's all about the circulation up there. The reason the ginkgo helps is because, well, how can it shrivel when you're still getting at the end of, let's say this is your brain, you know, at the end of the outer shell of it, how can it shrink? How can it shrivel when in reality you just boomed that circulation point there, you know, you just boomed it there again. So that, I guess that's what the ginkgo does, is it just keeps highlighting the edges as much as it can. You know what I'm saying? Because I guess that's what happens with those edges, when those edges aren't warmed up or highlighted, you know, with energy, with thought energy, we just, yeah. So that's where we're at. That's where we're at. I don't know about Roswell, but yeah. And I'm like, gosh dang it, why do I have to be so truthful? I'm so truthful to everybody, and it just seems like y'all take advantage of that. But anyway, yeah, I have this company called the Cavalry who calls me, and I'm like, why would they call me? Why would they try to chase me down when I've been the victim? And then I'm like, well, if I'm persecuted by this company, is there any way I can stop them? You know, if I'm being persecuted when I've been the actual victim of the theft, you know, it doesn't seem like the system is working so great, does it? So anywho, what else? Yeah, so I can't answer the telephone. Do you know what I mean? I can't answer the telephone because it's them. So they've stolen, you know, quite a bit of my life. When I've been the victim of the theft. So one would think, you know, all you bright-eyed and bushies out there could figure out some way to stop it, some way to get compensation for that kind of victimization. All right. Anyway, so what else was I gonna yab about? Yeah, I like North. I like North, but I don't think I can stay here in this cute here Bay Area. Yes. Oh, I did see those. I wanted to, oh my gosh, they're called arches. They're little houses, and they have a crew that shows up, and they build the foundation, they build the sides, they put the walls on, and they put the windows in, and they do that all in like 2 to 3 days. Usually 1 day is the main structure of the shell, and they're really good priced. So they're very, very competitive with like yurt people and that type of thing. And it's called arches. I believe the one thing they're going to get you on, though, is shipping. They do charge like a very high shipping rate. So I think to combat that is maybe some kind of distributorship here on the West Coast more. They have them in Houston, and they have them back near Texas somewhere, another place. So what I'm thinking, yeah, that company, oh gosh, they're cute. They're made out of, they have like the metal sidings with the colors, and then it's a real metal shell, just like a dinosaur, actually. It has that dinosaur skeleton shell on the inside. And you can get all kinds of different sizes. You can get 24 feet by 40. You can get huge ones, or you can get little tiny ones. And they're just darling. And great prices, very good prices. So for under $20,000, you can have them put it together, and hopefully all delivered, and a good size, a very good size to live in. That is for the bathroom. I believe it comes with the basic layout already done. But so it is one of those kind of neatos. And it always excites me when I see something under $20,000. And their little tiny ones are about $2,500. So that's very sweet. And those can be used in pretty much anybody's back garden. Very, very nice. Anyhoot. So yeah. What else was it? Yeah, I love the little pack rat company design. They made this. Theirs comes right off the truck, and then it flattens down on the ground so you can walk into it. There's no ramp. So they're little. I guess you call them pods. You walk in from the ground level, so that's pretty cool. And what was that other one? UPAC. UPAC was a great one because it had that. The UPAC one goes by linear footage, and so if you don't guess right, they'll just add on the extra footage. Like if you think you're 16 feet of trailer space, but now you end up needing 20, they'll just charge you the extra 4, and they'll just push back your area. And I believe they share that little pod. They're like 28 foot trailers. And I got quotes for about 4,000 to 4,500 with people helping. So that's a pretty cool one for a full trailer. But with that, you still have to drive. So yeah, with that you still have to drive. So yeah, it's very, very cool. There was a site out there. It was helpful. But anyway, yeah. What to do? This is a tough situation. Yeah, on my own facing the death of my father here. I really was in preference to be facing the death of my father somewhere else, you know, where it was, you know, his own home, where it was a little bit more comfortable, you know, he could, you know, unpack and have his life as best as normal. But anyway, what can I say? It's you know, you can wish all you like sometimes in your life for something, and doesn't necessarily mean it's going to happen. You know? So now I'm just a ginkgo biloba pusher, and that goes for pretty much all these older people, these older women that I've been meeting at the at any of these garage sales, these rummage sales. They are walking around with a little bit of a tart edge, I'll say. And, yeah. And it's not a tart edge in a good way. It's a tart edge in, you know, they just are that, I don't know, just give up. And I don't want to say mean, but yeah, there is that edge going on with some of them. And then I'm like, well, the other ones that are so nice, I'm like, well, maybe they're taking something. You know, maybe they're taking something. Maybe this is some kind of a drug habit going on that makes them nice. Possible. Because it seems like there sure is a majority of them that are grumpy. Anyhoot. Yeah, I lost that cat. I can't find it. I don't know where it went. Sorry. Just, it's gone. Didn't show up one morning, and that was that. So either somebody stole the cat and is feeding it back to health, or it died. But I don't smell anything, you know, of that pandemic odor. No, I don't, so no, nothing died like that. No. And then where am I next on the Dantaryanta? And my raccoon, I had to stop feeding because my father, I don't know, wouldn't let me have a raccoon. And so then I'm like, well, okay. It's tough because I give and I say things, you know, and I'm honest. And it just gets taken advantage of. I'm wondering what planet this is. And who are these people, you know? Who are these people that I depended on? I depended on you all to come up to the plate. You know, when it's all starting to look like it's just money. I'm only going to be there just because of money. You know, it's the only reason. You know, it just seems like when we're talking about siblings and elders, it starts to look like a money situation. No, I'm not going to participate. I don't want anything to do with it. You know, it just seems like this. No, this is just not enough. Not even enough to bother with. That's the saddest. That's the saddest situation. So, oh, what was this situation of moi, you know, who's pushed into absolute... what is it, immortal? I'll call it immortal poverty at this point. Because if I die this way, well, I guess my immortal self can always haunt you. All right. Well, enough of that.